Welcome back. We're continuing today our discussion on statistics. I'm Jason Grindstaff, and in one of the previous video series, we were looking at simple statistics from the standpoint of descriptive statistics. Today, we're continuing with probability. So this is another fun one for students because this will put your mind in a good twist. But as I mentioned in the other videos on statistics, it's really important that when students are learning statistical concepts, not to become overly frustrated, because statistics is much like learning a foreign language. The more that you practice with it, the better you become at it. So let's talk a little bit today about probability, and we're going to work through some fun examples for you. So in essence, probability, from a formula standpoint, is just the number of favorable outcomes divided by the total number of outcomes. So when we look at some examples, I think this is going to become a little bit clearer. So number of favorable outcomes over the total number of outcomes. So most students or most people understand a basic deck of cards. If you've never been introduced to a deck of cards, 52 cards, there are four different suits. We've got our diamonds, we've got our spades, we've got clubs, so we've got and hearts. All right, so our four suits. And we've got 2 through 10 as far as numbers. We've got the jack, we've got the queen, we've got the king, and the ace. So we've got 13 actual ranks. 13 ranks, 4 suits, 52 cards. So let's look at some simple probability questions. So if I gave you a 52 standard deck of cards, no jokers, and I asked you for the probability, okay, and this is how we write probability, the probability of an event. So if I asked you the probability of drawing a jack, now it could be the jack of hearts, it could be the jack of spades, it could be any one of those four ranks, okay? Even if you didn't know this formula, all right, you would say, well, there are 13 suits, okay, but there are only 13 ranks, but there are 4 jacks. Okay, so that makes sense. There's gonna be 4 chances out of 52. So, and that makes sense. But if we actually look at our formula, okay, that's exactly what we come up with. How many number of favorable outcomes? So how many jacks are there out of a standard deck of 52? Well, there are 4, okay? How many total number of outcomes? Well, the number of outcomes of drawing one card out of 52, there's 52 possibilities. All right, so we get 4 out of 52. All right, so simplified, that's going to equate down to 1 out of 13 times, or we can also write that as a percentage. We're going to get 7.7% of the time, we're gonna draw one of those jacks. 4 out of 52. All right, well, a little bit more complicated. Let's work through a few examples here. All right, so we get, what if we wanted to draw a jack or just another random card, let's say a 3. So now we want the probability of drawing one of those 4 jacks or one of those random 3s. So in essence, we're going to look at, we've got 4 out of 52, and then we've also got 4 out of 52. So that's going to equal 8. 8 out of 52, which is going to reduce down to 2 out of 13 times, or 15.4% of the time. Fair enough. Looking at another example, what if we said instead of a jack or a 3, what if I asked you to calculate the probability, so the probability of drawing a jack and a 3. So here you're going to draw 2 cards. You're going to draw the jack, hopefully, in order doesn't matter, but we're going to draw the jack and we're going to draw a 3 there. Okay, so let's walk through this. Let's just look at the jack first. So in essence, we're hopefully gonna draw a jack 4 out of 52 times. Okay. Now, if we draw one of those jacks 4 out of 52 times, how many cards are left in the deck? Right, that's 51 cards. So then the probability, so instead of plus, in addition, we're going to multiply this. So 4 out of 52 times, now we've got to come up with our 3, and we've got one less card in the deck. So 4 over 52 times 4 over 51. If our math is correct, we could simplify that to 1 out of 13 times 4 out of 51. But in essence, what that's going to give us is 4 out of 663 times, or about 0.6% of the time, we're going to be able to draw a jack and a 3. So there's just a few simple examples of how we would calculate probability. And when any time that we calculate probability, remember, always go back to your initial formula here. The number of favorable outcomes over or divided by the total number of outcomes. And if you stick to that formula, you should be able to walk through and calculate the probability for any problem. In the next video, we'll go a little bit deeper into a little bit more complex examples, but we're still going to be working with our same formula. See you next time.